Hello everyone, PallyTime here with TGN.TV. This is the continuation of my Dark Souls Season 6 playthrough. Still haven't gotten used to saying Season 6. So what has happened since the last episode? Let me get this elevator and I will show you. I went ahead and upgraded my fist weapon up to plus 10. And we also have a second one of these up to plus 10. I was farming these slugs down in Blighttown. And also while I was at it, I got my fiery fist weapon up to plus 5. So why do I have two of these at plus 10? Simply because one of those is going to become electricity, and the other one is going to be ascended into the Iron Golem fist hand, which we've talked about a lot. So the first episode is up now. I'm starting to get your guys' feedback, and I know I also said in the last episode I was going to record a lot more, but you guys know how much I suck at keeping that promise when it comes to Dark Souls. I suck at not recording more. Escape's fun. I need multiple characters. I think that would also help if I had multiple characters to play. See, when I'm recording, I pretty much only focus on one. Why are we going to Andre's house? We are going to Andre's house so we can go over here and talk to Sigmeier. We're going to have to start his quest chain off because we're going to be saving him, and I'm saying that with the utmost confidence this time. We're going to be saving him in this playthrough. I'm not going to let him die again. Hey, buddy.
Oh, forgive me. I was absorbed in thought. I am Sigmeier of Katarina. Quite honestly, I've run flat up against a wall, or a gate, I should say. The thing just won't budge, no matter how long I wait. And oh, have I waited. So here I sit, in quite a pickle, weighing my options, so to speak.
Man, these tree textures, they look terrible. Look at this shit. I never even noticed. These are terrible. Yeah.
Still closed.
Alright, so let's see if we can open that door for our good friend. And that means going down to Blighttown and ringing the second bell. The second bell of awakening. Now, on the way down to Blighttown, or I guess up in our case, I am going to be attempting to get the Power Within spell, which is going to take my power level up to 9,000. It's not over 9,000 yet. We're exactly even. We're exactly even at 9,000. I'm feeling pretty good about that. So let's take the shortcut back down. You know, I guess we've already gone to Blighttown, haven't we? I'll see you guys down there. Oh, shit. Oh, I got it, I think. I think we're good. Yeah! Alright, so we're down in Blighttown. Was not totally convinced I was going to land that jump. It's pretty crafty. I'm getting better at this whole jumping thing. Slightly better. Marginally better. Alright, so how hard are we hitting? Not too hard. But you know what? With Power Within, we should be fine. I think we'll be able to take down Kellogg's, no problem. Alright, let's go ahead and I'm going to rest at this bonfire. I believe I already kindled it. I sure probably didn't. I don't know. I can't remember. I don't think I did. I didn't need 10 Estus flats to farm slugs. Alright, so we reversed our hollowing. We're kindling the flame. Look at that manly chest just hanging out. It's a manly chest. Okay, so, what to do? We are going to be invaded by Maneater Mildred. Let's deal with her first, I suppose. Excuse me, weird bug thing. I have a date. I have a date with Bam Bam's sister. It's important. It is important. Okay, you are in a terrible spot, good sir. Hi, Mildred! Hello. Man, she's excited! She's meeting up with Bruno. Oh shit, you're going straight for the power attacks, huh? Girl. I have no idea when to parry that. You have zero poise. I never knew that. I guess it makes sense considering you're wearing a sack and you have a little wooden shield. Hey, I parried it and then fucking swung at a fly. All right, well, that's one fight down. Maneater Mildred was vanquished. We're going to get the butcher knife and 3 humanity. She was worth a decent amount of souls, actually. Hi, Shiva.
Hello again. Strange to meet away from the clan and the forest. But while you are here, how about some equipment? I love collecting these things. But I can only keep... And you know...
I can only keep so many, and you know I will sell them for cheap. The only one I'm even remotely interested in is the claws. And they're more of a dexterity weapon, whereas I'm going for a more strength-focused build. So I guess we're not going to be getting them. And I'm not going to be killing him right now, because I want to get the fog ring. So that means I need to stay in my covenant a little bit longer. Well, I have to beat someone else in PvP. This is disgusting. Okay, can we level up? I need another slot, or I need another point into attunement just to get one slot. Soul level 35. We have not come a long way, have we? Normally I'm used to being like soul level 50 down here. Well, okay, so we do have the toxic dart guy in this vicinity. And I don't know how to deal with him without using a ranged weapon, so we're probably going to be toxic. In fact, I'm almost certain we are, but we'll just run back down here and we will rest at the bonfire and then make our way back up again. Slow and steady wins the race in Blighttown. That's what I always never say. Think about that. Think about that for a minute. Okay. Well, these mosquitoes are going to be incredibly irritating. Mainly because I don't think I can really hit them when they're all freaking out like that. Alright, let's drink. This bug always gets stuck in the middle of the fucking walkway. Really irritating. And this is where we should aggro the dark guy. Yep, and we are toxic. So let's go try to deal with him very quickly. Very quickly. The faster, the better. And then we'll move back down to the bonfire. Reset our... What do you call these? Effects? I don't know. What do you call these? Status effects? That's what I'm going with. And this actually wasn't that bad. Having poison against these guys is so much easier. I'm used to them staggering me with every fucking hit. So irritating. Behind this wall here, we get the Wanderer set. Which, if I didn't need the poise, I would probably use the hood on. Although, without armor accompanying it, that probably looks... Yeah, that looks pretty fucking weird. Hurry up before I die. Here I am modeling fucking armor while I'm toxic and poisoned. Good job, Pallytime. Good job. Alright, let's get back down to the bonfire. Hey, don't mind me. Don't hit me either. Oh, just healed. Healed just in time. To be honest, I saw him before I dropped, but I thought he was dead. Alright, step one of getting power within complete. I'm still using that ring that protects me when my health is low. I've decided that's a really bad ring. Like, in between recording episodes, I've decided that's a pretty shitty ring. Because basically you get to the point where, yeah, you know, you get more defense, but it's only when you're at such a small, insignificant amount of health that it doesn't matter. That ring would only be useful if you had retarded amounts of vitality. Because obviously it... Oh, hold on. Obviously it starts triggering at a certain health percentage, and if your health is higher, then that percentage means you have more health. I know, astounding logic. I'm dropping such... Just unexplained knowledge bombs. No one's ever thought that way before in the history of Dark Souls, I'm sure. But okay, the toxic guy is dead. We should have no problems walking on through here then. We could just completely ignore these. You know, I didn't think about it, but killing this boss might be kind of interesting. The little mini-boss. He doesn't like it when you get into melee range, and obviously I don't have any reach. So I'm going to be fighting him in melee range. This might be really bad. I might have to do something like grab power within and run. I don't want to do that. Oh, God. This isn't it, is it? Don't I go up more? Yes. Is there any incentive to going that way? Is there anything that way? I don't think so. I don't think so, is there? We have another toxic guy mad at us. That's good. Hopefully I don't get toxic. Nice! Dodged it! Still just dealing with this poison. We still have 10 Astus Flasks, so I'm not even worried about that in the slightest. We should get this guy coming down the ladder. Hey, friend. Have some haymakers. One of these guys just killed... Why did I fall off? Bruno, what the fuck did you just... You guys saw that, right? I just get on the ladder and instantly fall? What the fuck was that? Okay. Alright, buddy. I don't know where you are. Okay. Lost track of him there for a little bit. How much health do you actually have? A lot. Okay. You're doing your scream? Thank you. I'll get a free backstab in. Get on the fucking ground. My camera is just going everywhere. It doesn't know what to do. Just punching him directly in the butthole. Take that, asshole. Literally. Okay, this part can kind of suck too, if I'm a little too advantageous. So we are going to not be a little too advantageous. The good thing about these guys is, it appears, that they are staggered every swing. Which kind of makes sense. They don't really have poise because they're naked. That guy's just floating. Look at him. Oh, now he fell. Good. Bye. Poison wore off. I'm sure we'll get poisoned again. Don't worry. I'll go ahead and top my health off as we move forward. There is one more toxic enemy ahead of us, and he is at the top of this ladder. I can hear someone moving. I can't tell if they're behind me or they're up here. Oh, he fell. Good. Fantastic. I don't think that fall will kill him. So I'm just going to kind of chill, wait for him to come back up, I think. Although I don't want to give other enemies time to aggro, so... Is he climbing back up? Yes, he is. He has one of those bodies things. Maybe it's like a totem, but he's gonna hit me with it. And here comes his friend. Hi, friend. Hello. I was right here. You're going the wrong way. Don't fall off. Punch him in the nuts. That'll teach him. See you later, buddy. Alright. I always have a hard time getting up that ramp for whatever reason. One more enemy to go. We're not on equal footing. There we go. You dead? Alright. What do I have for items? If I have some... I may have already used them. I kind of think I did. Yeah, I was going to use some fire bombs if I had them. But this is going to be awkward. Isn't he going to, like, freak out? If I fall down there, I am so fucked. Yeah, I just keep haymakering and backing up. Haymaker. Missed with that one. What's his health at? Can't tell. Alright, we're kind of making an impact here. Just not very eventful. Not very exciting. Oh no! Oh! Come on! Oh, I fell off the fucking ledge. You know, this place does get, like, significantly harder when you try to rush through it. I think a lot of this game does, though. Which is weird that I like it so much. Maybe it just means that when I speedrun stuff, it's kind of more impressive. I don't know. But Blighttown in particular, I've always thought if you just take your time, it's a lot easier. Like these guys, just kind of singling them out. Not getting ahead of myself, not rushing ahead. Really makes it kind of trivial, to be honest. Until they grab you, and then you're just raped, and then you just get fucked. Alright, here's a totem guy. Ouch. Do we have more friends coming in, or are we good? I think we're good. I think I already killed him. I don't know. Either way, I'm just gonna go. And assume and hope and pray that they don't follow me. You know what happens when you assume, though? You make an ass out of you and me. Did he land on the... He landed on the walkway. I got a lucky little shit. Bye! Oh, he's still falling. He just hit the ground. You see him? Nice. Nice. Alright, so, round two, asshole. Bruno versus scary crap thing. It's not that it's hard. It's just irritating. Gotta continuously reset my position. I think I may have aggroed another one of the little guys. Yeah, I can hear him behind me. You want some, bro? Where you at? Alright. I won't hear none of it then. These are connecting, right? Yes, they are. They're doing a whopping 45 damage. How much do my fire attacks do? 18. Alright, haymakers it is. Am I just paranoid? I keep hearing things behind me. Die, damn it. Couple more. One more. Good. That was the knockout punch, ladies and gentlemen. Wasn't it just so impressive? And there we go. Power within. Oh, parried an air attack, bitch. Get shit on. Oh, you are so embarrassed. That sucks. Power within. Now, what does that do? If you don't know, which most of you do, I'm not insulting anyone's intelligence here, but we're always getting new Dark Souls players around here. It's actually really encouraging. Really encouraging. I'm glad that a game this old still has a future. I mean, how many fucking games have I played on my channel where it's like we play it one time and then no one ever thinks about it again? Almost all of them. Anyway, Power Within increases your attack damage with like every kind of attack by a shit ton. Like, just shit ton. Oh, I already killed you. And basically, it makes it so you hit harder. And the drawback is that you lose a little bit of your health as it's going. Where the fuck am I? Where the fuck am I? What is it? Okay, this is the... Okay. Excuse me. Alright, so we have power within, we need to go attune it. Did I say what the drawback was? You lose health over time. And you can make that easier with the Lingering Dragon Crest Ring, which comes off of the sorcerer that I already killed. If you purchase that, it makes it a lot easier to deal with power within, to deal with the repercussions. Alright, we have one level up to do. I'm going to go with Endurance, I think. Maybe Strength. I don't know. We'll see. But I am going to get human form for this. Reverse hollowing, please. Gonna wait for the smoke to fade. I don't want to be stuck in old bonfires. Look at my leg right now. Oh my god, that is amazing. Just stretching out, guys. Just pre-game stretch, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Just getting a little limber. Okay, so we have 9 purple moss clumps. That is going to be plenty. That will be plenty. And we're going to use those moss clumps to get rid of the poison once we get to the other side. I did not slot power within. I'm a stupid-ass motherfucker. Let's go back and do that. I completely got distracted by my leg, just kind of like getting stretched out. Slot power within. Don't level up. Attune magic, power within. Fantastic. What else do I have just sitting here? Not much. Okay. If this guy's sign comes back, I'll summon him. I don't care. He's probably trying to get into the Sunbros or something. They would stay for more than a fucking second. I love that we have, like, an aura because of the wolf ring. That's pretty cool. Okay, what's up, guys? Don't mind me, I'm just Bruno. Bruno the Boxer. That's my name. I can't take this. You're a piece of shit. Plus rating. Alright, 5 seconds. That's all you have. And then I'm leaving. Oh, we have a winner! Will he connect? He's in a mixture of the Wanderer set as well as the Ninja set. I forgot what it's called. He has a heater shield. Is that a side sword? Balder side sword? That's pretty cool. Will he actually connect? Will anyone connect to my game? We shall see. Well, I guess I need to put my pyromancy hand on as well, don't I? There we go. No one? No one gonna join me today? Okay, well. We tried. We tried to do jolly cooperation. You guys can't fucking criticize me for that. I love the invaders that come into Blighttown. Those guys are fun. Because most of the invaders that I've seen in Blighttown try to poison you. I'm just like, what the fuck? What's the point? Everyone in Blighttown has purple moss clumps. Why would you try to poison them further? I don't get it. They're just going to be prepared for it. I saw a video of a person who invaded... Someone failed. No shit. Of a person who invaded in the depths and tried to curse people. Now that was a dick thing to do. Holy shit, that's an asshole thing to do. I would be furious. I'd be furious with a motherfucker. So, what advantages do we have going into Kellogg? Well, not very many, if I'm totally honest. We're not going to be outputting very much damage. Our offhand is completely useless because it's fire damage, and she's a lava-spitting spider woman, so we're not going to... I mean, that's not going to do anything for us there. I would say our biggest advantage is the simple fact that we are incredibly nimble. And the fact that we have fast attacks. So we can get in and out, and we can do our damage, and then we can leave. And that's going to be a huge part of this fight, I feel like. So, if the game would allow me to, I would like to get Man-Eater Mildred in here. There you go. Thank you. I'm sure this other guy won't connect. But Man-Eater Mildred, she never lets me down. Bam Bam's sister, she is here to stay. She's looking out. She's looking out for a man. Hey, girl. I just kicked your ass a little bit ago. You put on some weight. Ew. Mildred. What have you been eating? All right, well. Everyone always thought Bam Bam was the prettier twin. That's all I'm saying. Hey, titties. Enjoy, guys. I forgot they were here. I know I have female subscribers. Do you think that's a little sexist? Is that womenizing a little bit too much? I don't know. Oh, we are doing a whopping 50 damage a swing with Power Within. That is not a lot. Hopefully Man-Eater Mildred can get in here, do a little bit of damage. That would be very convenient. I would appreciate that. I'm kind of standing in the safe spot. The only attack that can hit me is that lunge that she's doing now. As long as I stay to the side. So, is she exploding? What's she doing? It's making a lot of noise for some reason. Oh, this might be the explosion, and I can't move! I was pinned behind a leg. Fuck. Drink right here. confidence. Yeah. I somehow keep getting pushed in front of her. She's gonna explode again. Man-eater Mildred, you are not helping. I brought you in here to help me. If I wanted to fail at this fight, I could have done it myself. Ouch. I made the stupid mistake of getting in front of her again. She just fucking landed on me. Where's that lava at? We died? What? Oh shit. No! I've decided against using Maneater Mildred. I don't need to make the boss harder for myself. And I also just wasted a poison thing. Good. I'm gonna unequip my pyromancy hand out of my right hand, put it in my left hand, and the reason for that is I want to be applying some gold pine resin. Now, she is very resistant to lightning for the most part, but honestly, at this point, I'll take any extra damage output that I can get. So, before we go in, let's chest bump and we'll put lightning on her hand. All right. Our souls are conveniently right by the door. It's good. Going with the lava spew, first thing. So by Maneater Mildred not being here, the boss is going to have a smaller health pool. So we're gonna be able to kill it a little bit faster. Which I'm all for. She's acting weird today. You feeling okay, Kellogg's? You're doing some weird shit. I mean, that was like a half second lava spew. What the fuck is that supposed to do? Did I just call her Manny or Mildred? I'm so out of it. I think I called her Kellogg's. I don't fucking know. I'm sure you guys will let me know what I called her. Our pine resin wore off. Let's get into the safe spot. Here we go. More pine resin. Oh, she's gonna explode. Go! Just made it out. Just made it out. Like a badass. I don't know what that is, but I don't like it. What was that? The fuck attack was that? Okay, let's move her back over to this side. I kind of want to get away from all this lava. And I do know that Power Within is killing me, but I'll be fine. Don't you worry. You're doing that again, huh? Oh, God. Not the ideal setup. That height advantage she had there sucked. I'm gonna stand here and try to heal. It's gonna lava spew right into me. Dodge just in time. Holy shit. Stop moving. Stand still. It'll make this a lot easier for me. I would really appreciate it. Power Within is worn off. Pine Resin is worn off. So we are just chipping away 35 damage at a time. This doesn't look good. I'm gonna try to heal really fast. Another lava spew. Oh no, where am I? Oh, I am neck deep in lava. I'm sure we're just fine. Our skin will recover from that. We're a fucking boxer. We'll be just fine. She repositions in... Oh, an explosion! Ah! She repositions in the middle of that lunging attack she does. I never realized that. Okay, let's drink again. Just a little bit more damage to go. Another lava spew. I'll take advantage of that. Why are they hitting me now? Roll! A little more. She's almost dead. And there was the knockout punch. Soul of Kellogg's. Twin humanities. How many souls we get for that? How many souls are we looking at? 20,000. 20,000, not bad. Not too bad. Okay, before we ring the bell, might as well come down here and say hello to Kellogg's sister.
Oh dear, what have we here? Are you a new servant? Then you shall.
Oh yeah, I should have said yes. I was just being honest.
The nerve of you.
I was just trying to be honest.
The nerve of you. Be gone. Be gone.
Oh damn it, I'm gonna have to kill him! Fuck.
The nerve.
I'm sorry. I meant yes. Alright, fuck it.
I knew it. You will not get away with this.
I'm sorry. I answered wrong. That was all. I was gonna be friendly. I deserve every bit of... Oh my god, how am I not dead? Oh. That ring that I was shit-talking earlier just saved the fuck out of my life. Look at that wolf ring doing its job, too. I didn't even care I was being attacked. I'm sorry I just killed your only bodyguard. Now someone else is probably going to come in here and kill you. But for right now, it won't be me. I just wanted to rest on your bonfire. Fuck, I'm sorry. Sorry I killed your doorman. He wouldn't let me in, fucking asshole. He would have let me in if I said yes, it was my fault. But that's not the point. Point is, he's a fucking asshole. Alright, so we have that bonfire for later use when we get our Lord Vessel. But for right now, let's ring the second bell. Homeward Bone. Now, normally I would use that Homeward Bone to get out of here, but we just rested that bonfire. So I'm going to make my way back up to the surface, and in the next episode, we're going to be heading into Sen's Fortress, one of my favorite zones. I love Sen's Fortress. It's really fun. It's really fun. But alright guys, as I'm going to go ahead and word some things, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video here. I'm going to stop getting ahead of episodes, I promise. Now that I have Sen's Fortress opened, I'm completely satisfied, and I'm going to wait for you guys to catch up. I'm sure next video I'm going to be apologizing again for not working. But I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I hope you guys are enjoying the series so far. The first episode got really, really good reception. Probably the best reception out of any of my Dark Souls series so far. Or maybe I was just in a good mood today and it seemed like it, I don't know. But it's fun. This is certainly challenging. Certainly challenging. But I hope you guys enjoyed today's video today. If you did, please be sure to hit the thumbs up button below. Leave me a comment down below as well. And if you are new to my channel, hello there. You want to become a Pally Bro? Go ahead and hit the subscribe button. Instant Pally Bro-ness for yourself. That is right. I'm gonna stop talking now. Okay, bye.